Hello everyone, it is Taylor and I am here to do my first ever Month's End Favorites video. I'm totally going to come up with a better name for the series, but instead of doing a wrap up every month, just because I read different amounts of books every month depending on what's going on with life, I decided I was going to do a favorites video every month instead. And in this series, so this is the first one for April, my favorites in April, but for the series what I will do is I will say my favorite book that I read this month, my favorite movie or TV show that I've watched this month, my favorite beauty product this month, favorite food this month, and fifth and finally my favorite random thing this month, which could literally be like another book, TV show, like anything I really like this month. And yeah, so let's get into it. Let's maybe start with my favorite movie that I saw. And I honestly can't remember if I saw it in April, but I'm so certain that I did. Like, I don't think I saw this in March. But without further ado, that was Love, Simon. I read the book Simon vs. the Homo Sapien Agenda, and stay tuned for a Love, Simon book versus movie video coming out in about a month where I'll be comparing the two, but I would give the movie 4.5 out of 5 stars. It was so good. I didn't cry, but the friend that I went with cried. She told me she wasn't gonna cry, and she cried like 3 times. But I think it was a really enjoyable one. It did the book, honestly, justice. And I think it's a really cool message, an important message, and a great movie for families and, you know, anyone really. I think it's a coming of age story that people of all ages can relate to from different aspects. Of the movie that were presented, but it was really good, funny, heartwarming, and I did really, really enjoy it. So that was my favorite movie this month. So why don't we say, what should we do next? My favorite book, and that is a book I actually picked up, and I read this in like 3 days, and that is Illuminae, the first one in the Illuminae trilogy, by Amy Kaufman and J. Kristoff. I know Obsidio, so the final one in the trilogy, just came out, I think, a month or two ago, and everyone loves this trilogy. There's high praises for it, and I can totally see why. I absolutely loved this book. I plan on picking up the other 2 books in the series before the end of the summer, hopefully. Fingers crossed I can get them either out at the library, find them in my local bookstores, and then I'll be doing a full review on the series. But for this book, I would have to say I gave it 5 out of 5 stars, yeah, 5 out of 5. The concept of the book, the sci-fi aspects of it, all of it was so well done. And what I really enjoyed was the different types of way that the writing was presented. So it wasn't just a novel with your typical, just, you know, a typical novel. It had different aspects of text messages and emails and surveillance footage and all these different things of files. Illuminae files, so all these different files to tell this really incredible story. And it's an easy read, so even though it's so thick, it's super easy read. And I love the aspect of AI in here, artificial intelligence and sci-fi. Those are really cool themes when you do read them, so I liked it a lot. So 5 out of 5 stars for this, and that was my favorite book this month. What should we do next? Why don't we do my favorite food? So my favorite food this month is one that I ate like 3 times in a week. In 1 week, not every week, but in 1 week, and that was Eggs Benedict. I was moving out of university this month, and when you're moving out, I don't know about you all, but there's a lot of eating out, especially because for me, I go to school in one city and have relatives in the other city, in the same province. I know this is complicated, but anyways, we had to drive down from my university with all my stuff to the other city before we could fly home for the summer. It was a very long process, and between just packing up and driving down to my aunts and uncles and all of that travel, there was a lot of Eggs Benedict in, and I'm not complaining. I really enjoyed it a lot, probably too much, but breakfast for dinner, you can't go wrong. And then my favorite beauty product is from Lush, and this is the Jasmine and Henna Fluff Ease. It is a hair treatment. Sorry, I'm trying to get the glare out. So it is a hair treatment, and it is a pre-wash treatment to get control of fluff and untamed hair leaving it soft and shiny, and it smells amazing. I have really enjoyed using this. I'm actually almost out of this first bottle, and I have ordered my second bottle of it, which I don't typically do with beauty products. I change it up way too often. I'm not consistent at all. So I'm glad to have found something that I really enjoy. And for those of you that don't know what Lush is, I think it's pretty common in the States and Canada. It's actually from Canada, fun fact. But it is this big beauty store, all natural ingredients, and the fun thing is, if you see that sticker there, it is a sticker of who packaged and made the product, so it's super, super cool, and I believe this is vegan. It is vegan, so for all of you out there who want, you know, very holistic, natural things, Lush is the place to go. And lastly, I have my random favorite, which for this month is my favorite dress. It is, I'm gonna have to back up, a dress from Forever 21. And it has all these really pretty flowers and this kind of cinched in waist, and it's nice. I'm a short person, but it goes above my knees, and I picked it up from Forever 21 because I had a store credit, and I absolutely love it. I've worn it so much, and I think I'm going to get a lot of wear out of it this summer because I think it's the perfect summer-fall dress. So those were my favorites this month, and I'd love to know what your favorites were this month, so comment down below. Unfortunately, I know I said that I would do this every month. I will not have a May's favorite out. I will have a May/June favorite out. Because I'm going to be going to Quebec for 5 weeks to do a French immersion program for a university credit. So I have been stockpiling all my videos, and you'll see a whole bunch of videos come out, so this won't change anything, but I won't be able to do a May favorites. So keep an eye out at the end of June for a May/June favorites, and it'll probably be a little longer. Maybe I'll do my favorite from each month, like pick one from each month. But we'll see how it goes. But let me know if you like this type of a wrap-up for each month, or if I should just stick to strictly books. But let me know. Anyways, I hope you're having a great day, and I'm gonna see you next time. Bye, y'all.